to bring this inhuman torture being committed on the Professor Jain Sai Baba on the by the state in the press. Invite D. Raza, former member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha, to take the seat, sir. Rights of disabled to take the seat, sir. Next, I would request Professor Nandita Narayan, former Duta President, to take the seat, ma'am. Then I would request Professor Parminder Singh, Association for Democratic Rights, Punjab, to take the seat, sir. To take the seat, ma'am. Next, I would request Sanjay Kar, filmmaker, to take the seat, sir. Request Vasantha, wife of Dr. G.N. Sai Baba and women's rights activist, to please take seat. I would request senior advocate of the Supreme Court, Prashant Bhosar, to take the seat, sir. Now I would like to take over the stage.
Thank you very much, friends, on behalf of the Committee for Defense and Release of Professor G.N. Sai Baba, whom, as you know, has been a teacher of Ramla Lalan College. A scholar, a poet, and a human rights activist, 90% disabled, wheelchair bound, suffering from innumerable ailments, not accused of any violent incident, not accused of being responsible for any violent incident, only accused of being a member of a banned organization, and many loopholes even in the evidence produced for that. As you know, since then, many more people have been incarcerated. Poets, scholars, human rights activists, lawyers, people who defend us. People have been incarcerated for simply caring for others, for the underprivileged, for speaking up for tribal rights, for Dalits, for Adivasis, because they come in the way of development. These are words used in the judgment. You are hindering development. Whose development? So these questions have become more center stage today because of the massive farmers' agitation. Whose development are we talking about? If this country is not meant for 90% or 95% of its people, for its Dalits, the Adivasis, for its women, for the farmers, for the workers, for the students, for the teachers, for the journalists, then whom is it meant for? So these are the questions that have now come more before the public eye. Those who thought that maybe some people may have, why have they been arrested and maybe they did something, are now very clear that you don't have to do anything, you just have to be humane, you have to care about the other, you have to do your job, you have to report honestly, you have to fight for your rights honestly, and you will not get, you will be denied justice, false cases will be put against you, you will be incarcerated, and for years even the trial will not take place, you will not even be given bail. And that in our country, justice is not blind the way it is supposed to be. Justice looks at the face of the person who is standing before it and will decide whether to give bail or not to give bail. If you are a Maya Kot Nani, or if you are a Babu Bajrangi, or if you are a Pragya Thakur, then all rules will be bent. You will be given bail, you will be released. There will be a complete U-turn in the judgment. you will be given, you know, even for a mild medical problem, you will be given medical bail. But if you're a Sai Baba or a Sudha Bharadwaj or so many people who are now, 16 people accused falsely, and the false case is absolutely clear from the findings of Arsenal, Massachusetts-based company, forensic firm, which has got hard evidence that evidence was planted on Rona Wilson's laptop and so many others subsequently. No investigation has been done about that. Nobody seems to be bothered. Instead, you have more and more people are incarcerated, including now, of course, recently climate strike activist. Recently, we tried to celebrate International Women's Day in our university. Universities are now the focus. The police tells us that we have been told to focus on universities because the next big agenda of the corporates is the loot from education, education business, online teaching, which is a farce, and how to loot the people of India and give them nothing in return. Take, privatize all government institutions, including those of higher education. So this is what is happening. We try to celebrate International Women's Day, where there were eminent speakers, women who have fought for the rights, their rights and others' rights, who were going to speak, and they were attacked by the ABDP. And the police, instead of doing anything about the ABDP, had actually helped them to disrupt the program. And if some of us had not intervened as teachers, they might have beaten up the participants more brutally and put false cases against them. This is what is happening. There are complete double standards. So at this point of time, you know better than all of us know, in fact, or you know as well as we do, how much the journalists have to face. What is being done to journalists today? So many are already behind bars. So it is up to you and us and all of us together to save our country. And that is why today, particularly in the case of G.N. Sai Baba, who apart from all his other numerous ailments and being 90% physically disabled, wheelchair bound, contracted COVID on the 13th of February. Before that, he was not allowed, in a shocking travesty of human rights, not even allowed to go and meet his ailing mother, who died without seeing her son, and was not even allowed parole to go and participate in her last rites. What could be more inhuman than that? His condition is not at all good. As speakers will tell you, Professor Sai Baba's wife, Basanta, is here. She will tell you about the latest medical condition. So we are here to demand his release on bail, his proper medical treatment in a proper hospital where he can get proper attention instead of being locked up in that Anda cell where he cannot get any medical help. So friends, with that, I would like to invite, first of all, Professor Parminder Singh, Association for Democratic Rights in Punjab. Professor Parminder Singh.
Friends, Dr. Nandana Narayan has introduced the subject of today's press conference. I would not go into details of how Professor Sai Baba was arrested, how is he kept in jail these days, in spite of his failing health, in spite of his frail body, and his lasting illnesses, and how was he imprisoned for life, even without any solid proofs. Professor Narayan has also given to you the other instances of incarceration of those persons from India who speak the truth, especially who speak for the people, for their demands and aspirations. So these things are very clear, these things. I would like to talk about two, three things. Why is this thing happening? Why is a person like Sai Baba imprisoned for life? Only one answer I think which should be focused upon today is his stringent opposition to those policies of the Indian state which are playing havoc with the lives of the common people here, especially the tribals, Dalits, and nowadays it has become very clear the peasants also. All these things are in a way interconnected. It was very early in this century when Prime Minister Manmohan Singh talked about the greatest danger to Indian democracy from what he called or what he characterized the left-wing extremism. It was only a euphemism to hide the real intent of the government at that time and even of the present government. It's a part of history of our very recent people's politics. The people in different parts of India, especially in central India, started fighting against the predatory moves of the big corporates for acquiring their natural resources, which include the land, the water, and especially the minerals of that area. We have a glorious past of the tribals in fighting against these predatory acts of the Indian state and of the big corporates. It's with this intent in mind that these predatory acts must be opposed, that democratic persons like Sai Baba start to raise their voice against these policies, the policies of the new liberal regime of present times. I'm also a part of the struggle. In Punjab, since that time, we organized a democratic front against Operation Green Hunt. And very specifically, we tried to defend not only the rights of the tribal people from these acts, from these neoliberal policies, but we also raised our voice against the repression that loosed upon the tribals of Chhattisgarh, of Jharkhand, of Odisha, or raise our voice again for the fight that these tribals were waging against the immoral, illegal acquisition of the natural resources, as for instance in Odisha. And it is in this context that when we raise our voice against the onslaught on these democratic people under these policies by the governments in India, especially the present BJP government, especially this government, if you take into consideration the entire process of imprisoning persons like Sudha Bhardwaj, Rona Wilson, Gautam Devlakha, and other people like that, then I think two things must be mentioned. One, that today is the time to defend the right of people of India to speak against acquisition of the natural resources, to speak against the onslaught of their livelihoods, to speak against the attacks upon the natural resources. Secondly, it's again a bounden duty imposed upon all the democratic people of India, upon the democratic organizations of India, to speak against the rulers. Earlier you had the Congress rulers, and now particularly keeping in mind the entire gamut of the communal onslaught on the people of India, This means the present BJP government, where we need to raise our voice against it for incarcerating these democratic-minded people like Sai Baba, Sudha Bhardwaj and other people, and also to raise our voice against any kind of attack upon the rights of the people to democratically defend their lives, their livelihoods, and their way of life, their culture also. It's that time. All these things are anyway interconnected. Lastly, I would like to mention that the present day peasant struggle, which is going on these days, and now on outskirts of Delhi, is also a part of the same struggle which was waged earlier by the other exploited sections of Indian people, of tribals and Dalits. But here again, we have the same kind of problem. The peasants fear one thing, that their land would be acquired under one pretext or the other. You know, I would like to emphasize very clearly that under this regime of new liberal policies, it's not simply the basic employment or livelihood which is under threat, but the entire source of nature, which is our people's source, which includes the land, water and minerals. And all these things are under serious attack of these corporate world, aided and abetted by the Indian state. In order to defend the people of India, the first requirement is to defend the right of the people to see through this game, to raise their voice against this kind of onslaught, this kind of attack, and by doing this, to defend the basic right of the people of India to live a life of dignity, to live a fulsome life without any kind of attack upon these forces. In this context, Professor Sai Baba becomes absolutely legitimate, because the incarceration of Sai Baba is a part of this overall attack by the Indian state upon our people. Now, it's another thing to mention, and which is very important, that this state is proving to be absolutely blind to the basic conditions of a human being. And given the frail, weak health of Professor Sai Baba since his childhood, along with the ailments that he is suffering from these days, we demand his immediate release, at least on bail, from incarceration, so that he is able to live his full life naturally. This government, it seems, is bent upon robbing him of this life. And it's because of this right to life that we are demanding his release. It's because of our commitment to fight against the unjust, exploitative new liberal policies that we are demanding this kind of release. It's because of resolve to raise our voice for, against, and fight against the dictatorial attitude of the present Indian regime that we raise our voice against that incarceration and also demand his release. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Parvinder Singh. Now I will request, Professor G.N. Sai Baba ki wife, Vasanta se, ki wo hume aur aapko batayin ki latest situation Professor Sai Baba ki health ki khas taur se kya hai. Vasanta ji.
Good morning, काल के अधीन नहीं तो फरवरी 9 को फोन कॉल आया था मेरे को। उस समय साई का तो ये सिम्टम्स है, साई फोन में बात करते समय भी ब्रेथलेसनेस एंड थ्रोट इन्फेक्शन है, गले में बात भी ठीक से आई नहीं, वो पूरा पता चल रही है वैसे बातों में भी वो बताया था मेरे को। कोविड सिम्टम्स है, टेस्ट भी पता नहीं चल रही और स्मेल भी पता नहीं चल रही, ये फिर कोविड टेस्ट करवाया मुझे तो कोविड टेस्ट नहीं करवाया जेल में बोला था। हम फिर तुरंत जेल सुपरिटेंडेंट को इनको कोविड टेस्ट तुरंत करवा लीजिए, ये सिम्टम्स ऑलरेडी है इनके, ऐसा हम चिट्ठी लिखी थी। इसके बाद उसको लेके गए थे 12 तारीख को, इनको कोविड 19 पॉजिटिव आ गए ऐसा टेस्ट रिजल्ट आया, तब 13 को हमको फ़ोन करके बताया था हमें। फिर इस ऐसा सिचुएशन है वहाँ इनका बैरक में 25 लोग हैं, उसमें 10 लोग कोविड पॉजिटिव आ गए, बट किसी को भी हॉस्पिटल में एडमिट नहीं किया। ये साई बाबा का इश्यू में और खतरा ज़्यादा है, एक्चुअली ये पोलियो अफेक्टेड है पूरा बॉडी, ऐसे पोलियो अफेक्टेड लोगों का सीधा हार्ट का इफेक्ट होने का खतरा ज़्यादा है कोविड में। एक कोविड इन्फेक्शन एनी टाइम एनी बॉडी ऑर्गेनिक ऑर्गन्स में सीरियसली अटैक कर रही, फिर वो इतना एडवर्स सिचुएशन हो सकता है वो कोई बता नहीं सकते हैं, क्योंकि हम हमारा फैमिली में बहुत हम लास्ट 2020 में यही देखा था, हमारा रिलेटिव्स में भी खुद नज़दीक लोगों का डेथ हो गई और कोविड से बच के फिर डिस्चार्ज होने के बाद भी पोस्ट कोविड इफेक्ट्स के वजह से भी डेथ हो गई। ये सब देख के हमें घबराहट हो गई पूरा, ये क्यों हॉस्पिटल में एडमिट ही नहीं कर रहे। हम फिर तुरंत महाराष्ट्र चीफ मिनिस्टर के, होम मिनिस्टर के और ADG प्रेजेंस पुणे, इन लोगों को सबको भी लिखा था। ये नॉर्मल पेशेंट्स का अलग है, साई बाबा इज ए 90% डिजेबल्ड एंड इनकी लेफ्ट हैंड भी पैरलाइज हो गई वहाँ 2014 इनकार्सरेशन के वजह से, मिसहैंडलिंग किया था जब अरेस्ट किया उस समय, वो लेफ्ट हैंड में मजल्स एंड नर्व्स डैमेज हो गई, लेफ्ट हैंड पैरलाइज हो गई। ये पार्शियली पूरा इसको दो लोग 24 आवर्स अटेंडेंस होना चाहिए, उसको डेली रूटीन बाथरूम जाना, कहीं खाना पीना, ये सब के लिए भी 2 हेल्पर्स चाहिए। वो अगर पलंग पे लेट गए तो खुद उठ नहीं पाते हैं, उठेंगे तो व्हीलचेयर में बैठ नहीं पाते हैं, फिर दो लोग उठा के पलंग से व्हीलचेयर में बिठाना है और व्हीलचेयर से लेके टॉयलेट का सीट में बिठाना है। ये सारे इतनी छोटी सी अंडा सेल में इनको खेद करके अभी भी वही रखा हुआ, इसमें ही ये हेल्पर्स के साथ ही जी रहे। बट क्या खतरा है मुझे समझ में नहीं आती, अभी नंदिता मैडम भी बताया था, बाबू बजरंगी, असीमानंद, प्रज्ञा ठाकुर, ये सब लोगों को मेडिकल ग्राउंड्स में बेल मिल रही और एक्विटल भी हो रही केसेस, और मेडिकल ग्राउंड्स में आके क्या किया, ये पार्लियामेंट इलेक्शंस में पार्टिसिपेट किया और पार्लियामेंट में भी बैठ गए। ये पूरा टोटल 100% डिजेबल्ड है, एक तरफ ओनली इनकी हार्ट बीट चल रही और माइंड चल रही, इसी बाकी देखे तो लिटरली हर चीज़ की इसको उठाना है बिठाना है सब, ये एवरी टाइम 24 आवर्स 2 हेल्पर्स का से ही चलता है। वैसे इनकी बेल देने से क्या खतरा है, इतनी स्टेट क्यों इतनी डरते हैं, ये इन्होंने क्या किया है, ऐसा हमें तो कोई गलत नहीं किया है। ये एक टाइम में ये अभी रिसेंटली भी फ़ोन आया था थोड़ा फरवरी एंडिंग तक इसका तो सिम्टम्स वही है, बुखार कम हो गई बट सीवियर हेडेक है और इसका थ्रोट इन्फेक्शन ऐसा है, नोज ब्लॉक है, बीच में इसका टेम्परेचर बहुत ड्रेस्टिकली कम डाउन हो गया तो पलंग से भी नीचे गिर गया, ऐसा दो तीन बार भी हुआ था, कोई हेल्पर भी नहीं उठाने को, फिर ये होश में आके चिल्लाया तब आके इसको अटेंड किया, ऐसा हालत में है क्योंकि कोविड पॉजिटिव आने के बाद इनको हेल्प करने के लिए एक दूसरा कोविड पेशेंट को ही अलर्ट किया। ये क्या, देखिए इतनी हरकत क्यों, ये हॉस्पिटल में अटेंड करेंगे तो हॉस्पिटल में वहाँ ट्रेंड नर्सेस और मेडिकल्स के वो देख लेते हैं ना, ऑलरेडी कोविड पेशेंट इतना वीकनेस में है, वैसा दूसरा कोविड पेशेंट इसको कैसे हेल्प करेगा, वो खुद रेस्ट लेना है, उसको इनका देखभाल के लिए एक पर्सन को इस अंडा सेल में डाल दिया तो ये दोनों का कैसे हरकत, इतना हरकत है, दोनों का हालत कैसे है। देखिए वैसे क्यों एडमिट नहीं किया, ये बाकी जो झूठे में बोल के बहुत लोग आते जा रहे कि इनका तो वैसा ही किया, अभी लास्ट 4 डेज बैक कॉल किया था इन्होंने, फीवर कम डाउन हो गई बट ये फूड पोस्ट कोविड में भी बहुत ठीक से होना चाहिए, खाना और हेल्थ केयर ठीक से होना चाहिए क्योंकि वो ऑलरेडी कोविड अटैक से वीकनेस हो जाते हैं, बीपी भी डाउन है इनका, अभी पूरा हेल्दी फूड चाहिए, ड्राई फ्रूट्स, फ्रूट जूसेस और अंडे, मिल्क, ये सारे चाहिए, बट कोविड जब पॉजिटिव है उनको जो उस समय इनका दूध और अंडे तो देते थे खाने के लिए, अब ये स्टॉप कर दिया, पोस्ट कोविड सिचुएशन और खतरा है, उसमें भी तो और इनकी हेल्थ केयर चाहिए ना, बट वो हेल्दी फूडे नहीं दे रही तो वो कैसे रिकवर हो जाएगा, आगे का कभी भी कोई भी कंडीशन हालत ख़राब हो के कोई एडवर्स सिचुएशन अटेंड हो सकता है, बट वहाँ जेल में कोई ऐसा इमरजेंसी सिचुएशन डील करने का सुविधा तो है ही नहीं, ओनली वो हेल्थ सेंटर जैसे ही है, वहाँ पैरासिटामॉल और पेन किलर्स वो ही गोली वाली मिलता है, बस इमरजेंसी इक्विपमेंट तो है ही भी नहीं है जेल में। फिर एक्चुअल क्या हुआ, ये अरेस्ट से पहले इनका हाई बीपी है और हार्ट पेशेंट है, पैंक्रियाटाइटिस प्रॉब्लम है, बट आफ्टर अरेस्ट इनकी 19 हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम्स आ गई, ब्रेन में सिस्ट है, गॉल ब्लैडर में स्टोन्स है, किडनी में स्टोन्स है और लेफ्ट हैंड पूरा पैरलाइज हो गई, नर्व्स एंड मसल्स डैमेज हो गए हैं, उसको 24 आवर्स इसमें लेफ्ट हैंड में पेन, सीवियर पेन होता है, बट वो जब शुरुआत में हॉस्पिटल में दिखाया नहीं, ट्रीटमेंट नहीं दिया तो वो मसल्स एंड नर्व्स डैमेज स्प्रेड होके पूरा हाथे हिला ही नहीं रही। अब 2019 में ये लेफ्ट हैंड में इनका स्वेलिंग आ गई, इन्फेक्शन आया था, वो इन्फेक्शन स्वेलिंग है, इन्फ्लेमेशन है अंदर मसल्स एंड नर्व्स में लेफ्ट हैंड में, तब बोले तो वो दिखाया, डॉक्टर बोला रेगुलरली इनको फिजियोथेरेपी चाहिए और एडमिट करने का लिए, गवर्नमेंट मेडिकल हॉस्पिटल डॉक्टर्स कहाँ था, बट वो एडमिट नहीं किया और ट्रीटमेंट नहीं दिया, खाली जब हम बेल के लिए डालते हैं, पेरियल के लिए डालते हैं, उस समय जल्दीबाजी इनको हॉस्पिटल लेके जाते हैं, फिर कोर्ट में कहते हैं हमें हॉस्पिटल में दिखाया, वो रिपोर्ट्स आना चाहिए और एक महीने का डेट लेते हैं, वैसे ही ये हरकत कर करके एक साल से ज़्यादा मेडिकल ग्राउंड्स में बेल के लिए चला के फिर बेल रिजेक्ट किया। उसके बाद मेरे मदर इन लॉ की इतना तबीयत खराब हो गई, वो खुद इनका बेटा को देख नहीं पा रही, तो वो बहुत